The archives of Faraday's local newspaper are a window into this small town's past. But among these dusty yellow pages, there are stories some people would prefer to forget.
This is September, 3 months before Frank died, and this is his advertisement. He ran it almost every week.
The man that died almost 50 years ago was Frank Morris, a successful businessman who owned a shoe repair shop. He was well liked by the entire community, and his white customers would often let their children play inside his shop. That, say investigators, was reason enough for the Ku Klux Klan to target him. And this is all that remains of Frank's business. That night in 1964, it was set on fire. Frank was forced to stay inside at gunpoint. He was last seen running from the corner of the building with his clothes on fire, and as he ran for help, he left bloody footprints on the road. 4 days later, he died from his burns. All facts that weren't clear until local reporter Stanley Nelson spent years investigating Frank Morris's death. He pieced together what happened that night by talking to witnesses and going through old police reports. What he found shocked him.
But the more you dug, the more you realized that there were some really bad people here, and that if what happened then were happening now, with the murders and beatings and whippings that were going on, we would be terrified.
But what's happened here isn't unusual. Across the Deep South, there are still around 70 unsolved murder cases, most of them brutal and racially motivated.
The Lord have a way of bringing justice. You know, it may be a long time coming, but he's get there.
But for people like Robert Lee, who remembers Frank Morris well, there is some comfort that Frank's murder may not have been in vain.
At least somebody said, let's find out what happened to this man and who was responsible. And now the world knows who Frank Morris was, they knows what kind of person he was, and have some idea who were responsible.
Despite fresh efforts to investigate these so-called cold cases, it's unlikely many people will be brought to justice. Witnesses are dying, memories fading, and perpetrators taking their secrets to the grave. But in Faraday, the memory of Frank Morris lives on, and for those left behind, that may be the only justice they get. Andy Gallagher, Faraday, Louisiana.